Remember that cinematic ad you just saw? That took multiple tools and dozens of failed attempts to figure out. But now, I've cracked a repeatable formula that works consistently. Today, I'm showing you the exact step-by-step process to create professional cinematic ads like this without the trial and error I went through. If there's enough interest, I'll make a behind the scenes showing the different approaches I tested. Hit like and comment if you want that lah. Let's dive in. Okay, first things first, let me show you what we're working with. This is a Nessie Labs purifying emulsion. Controls oil, minimizes pores, keeps your skin matte. My client needs this for digital signage. You know, those retail screens in their outlets. We're going for a luxury cinematic vibe. High-end, aspirational. The kind that makes people stop and look when they walk past. About 10 to 15 seconds and it has to feel premium. Here's the key. For predictable results, start with a static image first. Now, there are several ways to access Nano Banana, which is Google's Gemini 2.5 Flash Image Model. You can use Google AI Studio or the Gemini app directly, both solid options. But I'm using aigalaxy.app for two main reasons. First, no watermark on your images. Google AI Studio adds watermarks to all generated images. Second, aigalaxy has this AI-enhanced prompt feature that automatically improves your prompts, which is super helpful. And for this particular ad, I'm going to use my own face as the model. I mean, why not? My skin's not bad, what? Plus, I can control exactly how the beauty shot turns out. The free tier gives you 30 credits per month, no credit card needed. That's about 3 images to test the workflow. I'm on the pro plan, currently $5.99 USD per month on promo. Because I create ads regularly and need more credits. But you can definitely start free to see if it works for you. Let me show you how this works. Let's start with the product shot. This is our hero image. I'm going to use the product image from the Nessie website as my reference. For digital signage, I need to set this to 16:9 aspect ratio. Here's a really useful feature in aigalaxy, AI Enhanced Prompt. I'll write a simple prompt first, then let the AI make it better. So I'm typing, purifying emulsion bottle on white marble surface with water droplets, luxury skincare photography, studio lighting. Now, I'll just hit the AI Enhance Prompt button. Look at that! It transformed my simple prompt into something much more detailed. It added specifics about photorealistic quality, lighting details, depth of field, and even instructions to maintain the exact product branding. Let's generate. Nice, these look quite good. Unhappy with this one. Clean composition, perfect lighting. If you're not satisfied, you can always generate more variations. Now for the fun part, creating the beauty shot. I'm using my own face as the model for this one. I'm going to upload my reference photo here. Same thing. 16:9 aspect ratio. For the prompt, I want to emphasize that perfect matte finish and create that classic beauty commercial look. So I'm writing, close-up beauty portrait, woman wearing white off-shoulder clothing, perfect matte skin, no shine, flawless poreless complexion, soft studio lighting, shoulders visible, professional skincare commercial photography. Let me enhance this prompt. Let's generate. Perfect! This one captures exactly what I need. That luxury matte finish, professional lighting, classic beauty commercial aesthetic. This is going to work beautifully in the ad. Now we need one more image. This time, focusing on the ingredients. This shot will show what makes this product work. I'm going to use the same product reference image again, but this time with a completely different setting. Same 16:9 format, and for the prompt, a Nessie Lab purifying emulsion bottle with fresh brown seaweed algae, natural ocean rocks, coastal environment, botanical elements, soft natural daylight, organic luxury aesthetic, ingredient story photography. Let me just enhance this first. Let's generate. Very nice. The natural setting with the algae really tells the ingredient story. Now, we have all three static images already, ready to convert to video. Now we have all three static images ready. Just as a quick check, make sure you have clicked the download button for each picture from aigalaxy.app after you generated it. Okay, with those files saved, it's time to bring them to life with video generation. I'm using Google Flow. It's Google's AI filmmaking tool powered by Veo. You need a Google AI Pro subscription to access it, but they offer a 1-month free trial so you can test everything first. Now, here's a pro tip. For best results, use JSON format for your prompts. This gives you much more control over camera movements and gets you more cinematic results. Okay, before we even open Google Flow, we need to prepare our master prompt. For the best cinematic control, we'll use a structured JSON. I'm going to use Perplexity, but you can use ChatGPT, Claude, or any AI assistant that accepts image uploads. First, I'll upload both my images to the AI assistant. The product shot start frame and the lady's shot end frame. Second, we'll give it a simple prompt. We want the AI to do all the heavy lifting, both creative and technical. I will ask it this. Based on the two images I uploaded, image 1 is the start, image 2 is the end, please write a structured JSON prompt for Google Flow. The video should be a luxury commercial with a seamless transition from the product to the model. Please include keys for shot, transition, timing, and audio. Be creative. That's it. It's simple, clear, and tells the AI exactly what we want. It will think like a director and give us back a structured JSON with all the cinematic details and timings. I'll just copy that. Okay, now that I have my creative JSON prompt copied, now we go to Google Flow. So I'm here at Google Flow. I'll click New Project, and then I'll select the Frames to Video mode. This part is important. I'll click the first frame slot and select my product shot from my computer. The crop window appears immediately. I'll just make sure the framing is good and then click Crop and Save. You'll see it start uploading. And okay, now the first frame is in. Now I'll do the exact same for the last frame slot. I'll click it, select the lady's image. The crop window appears. I'll check the crop and click Crop and Save. It uploads. And now the second frame is locked in. Right, with both our frames set, I'll paste that creative JSON prompt we just copied right into the main prompt box. Now, look for the model options. Since we did our work upfront perfecting the JSON, we can go straight for the final version. I'll select Veo 3.1 quality. This gives you the full 1080p high-fidelity render with the best lighting and realism. Our prompt was designed for 8 seconds, which is a great length. Okay, let's generate. This will take about 1 to 2 minutes, so be patient.
Annecy.
Okay, let's see. Wow, that's nice! The camera movement is perfect and the transition is really smooth. That's a great first result. But the fun of this workflow is trying different creative ideas. Now I want to try something more sophisticated. What if the camera pushes into a single water droplet on the product? And as we get close, it reflects the model's face. And that reflection is what seamlessly transitions us to the final shot of the lady. See, this is the power of using a JSON prompt. We don't have to start over. I'm just going to go back to our Perplexity conversation and re-prompt it. Since it's the same chat, the AI already has our images. I'll just ask it to rewrite the JSON with this new droplet reflection idea. Let's try that. Okay, I'm back in my Perplexity chat. The AI remembers our images, so I'll just give it a new instruction. I'll type, that last JSON was good, but let's try a more creative transition. Please rewrite the JSON prompt with this new idea. Instead of a water blend, have the camera push into one of the large water droplets on the product. As the camera gets close, the droplet should reflect the model's face from the second image. This reflection should then expand to fill the screen and seamlessly transition into the final shot of the model. Heat the same JSON structure as before. Right, that's sent. The AI will now generate a new JSON for us that's built around this much more sophisticated droplet reflection concept. Let's see what it gives me. Okay, I'm back in my Google Flow tab. I have my new droplet reflection JSON copied. Now, on the video we just generated, I'm going to click the Reuse Prompt button. And look, it takes us right back to the frames to video setup, and our first frame and last frame images are already loaded. We don't have to upload or crop them again. This is a huge time saver. Now, I'll just delete the old JSON from the prompt box and paste in our new JSON for the droplet reflection idea. Okay, let's generate this new version. This will take another 1 to 2 minutes.
Annecy.
Oh yes! Look at that! The camera pushes into the droplet, you see the model's face in the reflection, and then it just blends. You know, now that I'm looking at it closely, it's not quite right. It's a very clever idea, but the reflection in that curved droplet is distorting her face. It looks a bit warped before the transition finishes. It's just not as clean as the first one. You know what? I'm going to use the first video we made. The simple direct water blend was actually more professional and visually better. That's a great lesson. Sometimes the simpler idea is the strongest one. Okay, so we have our first video locked in. Now we need our second video, which will be the transition from the model to our final product shot. I'm going back to my Perplexity chat. The AI still remembers the model's image. I just need to upload our new end frame, this beautiful shot of the product on the rocks by the sea. Okay, that's uploaded. Now I'll give it a new simple prompt. I'll type, okay, now I need a new JSON prompt. The first frame is the model's face. The last frame is the new product shot on the rocks. Please write a structured JSON prompt for Google Flow. Here's the creative idea. The video should zoom in close to the model's skin, and then seamlessly transition into the natural scene with the product. Please include keys for shot, transition, timing, and audio. Be creative. That's it. It's simple and it clearly communicates our new creative idea. The AI will handle all the technical details like the camera movement and the type of transition to make it look professional. Let's see what JSON it gives us for this one. I've got the new JSON from Perplexity. I read it and made a few minor tweaks to the prompt just to perfect it. So now I have my final JSON copied, let's go back to Google Flow. I'll select Frames to Video Mode. This time, for the first frame, I'll click the slot, select the model's image, check the crop, and click Crop and Save. It uploads. Okay, frame 1 is in. Now for the last frame, I'll click the slot, select our new product on the rocks image, check the crop, and click Crop and Save. Right, both frames are locked in. Now I'll paste our new tweet JSON into the prompt box. Again, we're going straight for the final version, so I'll make sure Veo 3.1 quality is selected. Okay, let's generate this second transition. This will take another 1 to 2 minutes. The first one is done. It's nice, but I think we can get a better one. Now, here's a tip. Even with the exact same JSON prompt, the AI will give you slightly different results each time. So if the first try isn't perfect, just generate it again. I'm just going to click the Reuse Prompt button. This keeps my images and my JSON prompt exactly as they were. Let's generate again. So after a few generations, we eventually got the perfect shot we wanted. Now Flow gives us these individual 8-second video clips. So you will still need some basic video editing skills to put them all together to tell your story. But you don't need a super professional tool. You can just use a simple app like CapCut to join the clips, add your music, and do your final sound editing. So, with all our clips generated, I've done that. Let me show you the final video with all our clips edited together and the sound design all done.
Annecy.
And there you have it. A professional high-end product commercial created using AI tools like aigalaxy.app, Perplexity, and Google Flow. As you can see, once you understand the workflow, especially using structured JSON to get cinematic control, you can create amazing results. If you're a business owner who wants to have ads like this done, or if you're an AI content creator who is capable of doing this work, I want to invite you to join our community. We're all at kampung.io. It's a place where we share tips, workflows, and help each other grow. So, I hope this tutorial was helpful. If you got any value from this video, please give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to hit that notification bell so you won't miss the next one. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.